determined, only optimistic, only hopeful, and only gonna fight until we win. Good to hear. Friends, this is not a Brexit deal. It is an assault on the rights of workers. It is an assault on environmental and social protections that people have fought for and struggled. Let's call it what it is. It is class war from above. That is what the Tories always wage. And friends, it's our conspiracy theory. Some of the Tories own mouths. 7 years ago, a group of Tory MPs published a book in which they said British workers were the worst idlers in the world, that too many people in Britain prefer relying to hard work. They amongst them was Liz Truss, Dominic Raab and Priti Patel, who now sit in the cabinet. Another Tory, Jeremy Hunt, who cheered on slashing tax credits to low-paid workers because it would make the workers hard as the Chinese. Boris Johnson himself, who declared the weight of employment regulation is now backbreaking and called for a bonfire of workers' rights. They've said it publicly. We don't need to read between the lines. For them, whether they voted Remain or Leave, they are united behind this deal because they want to toss the rights of working people on a bonfire. And that is why we have to fight, and that is why we have to win. They said take back control, but we know what they want to do. They want to give up control to Trump's United States of America, to strip our rights in a race to the bottom. When they talk about competing with the EU, they mean undercutting them and stripping those hard-won rights. And friends, whatever happens in the coming days, and we should say this to those Labour MPs, a small gaggle of Labour MPs. Labour was founded for one purpose alone, to advance the collective interests of working people. If you vote for a deal that strips the rights of working people, you have betrayed every basic reason your own party exists, and you will be disgraces and it will be all you are ever remembered for, damned by history. But friends, they are coming for our rights, let's have no doubt. And in the coming days, what they want us to do is this. They want us to be divided and fragmented and turn on ourselves. But we're not going to let them, are we?
No.
We're going to stand united whatever happens.
Yes.
And we're going to fight until we toss Boris Johnson and the Conservative Party out of office.
Yes.
Is that what we're going to do?
Yes.
Because the cause of our nation's turmoil and chaos is not migrants, it's not refugees, it's not benefit claimants, and it's not all the others the Tories have spent years scapegoating and demonising for all the injustices caused by the powerful. As long as the Tories are in power, this country will remain in turmoil and chaos, and we will never build a country running the interests of the majority, not the bankers and the tax dodgers who the Tories exist to represent, until we throw them out of office. All of them, Johnson, Priti Patel, Liz Truss, Dominic Raab, the whole shebang, out of office. So friends, we will march today. And whatever happens, we won't be defeated. Because there are battles that are won and lost, but there is a war to be won.
Yeah.
And throughout our history, if we think of all the rights and freedoms we have, if you look back at the struggles of the past, history is not a story of victory and success, victory and success. Sometimes it's setback and defeat, and then victory. Woo! Like the women who fought for the rights to vote. Woo! Like LGBTQ people who fought for their rights. Like workers who fought for their rights. Like those who fought racism and sexism, who were battened by police officers and spat out in the streets and demonised by the media and the political elite. Many times it felt hopeless and they felt alone and they were persecuted and hated. But they won and history damned those they fought. And we have to have that same spirit of our ancestors in the struggle ahead. So whatever happens, remember the courage and optimism of the giants on whose shoulders that we stand. And with optimism and determination in the coming weeks and the coming months, let's bring Boris Johnson and the Tories down and build a new society running the interests of the majority. Let's stand together, let's fight together, let's win together. Solidarity.
That was Owen Jones, who just suddenly appeared, the main commentator, just before the march is going to carry on towards Parliament Square.
We've got another announcement, but it's slightly more exciting. Whatever happens today, we can win. Whatever happens today, we're part of history. Whatever happens today, the people who are in this crowd today are part of a mass movement that this country has not seen in years and years and years. It is a unique movement, a mixture of the organised left, we put on rallies like this, of Remainers and social progressives. And we are a party, not a party. There's a man over there shouting about Brexit. Do you want to just like shout? When I say stop, you say Brexit. Stop!
Brexit!
Stop!
Brexit!
Stop!
Brexit!
Stop, stop, stop!
Brexit, Brexit, Brexit!
Please be quiet. Now, whatever happens today, that movement can go on and on and on. And whatever happens, we are going to need a movement that can fight for migrants' rights, that can fight for climate justice, that can fight for internationalism, and yes, that can bring us back into the EU if we have to, but can still stop Brexit before it happens. And we need an organisation to be at the heart of that. Another Europe is Possible was founded to fight the 2016 referendum campaign. We're here, we're louder, and with you, we will win this fight. If you're not already a member of Another Europe is Possible, please join us. We're the left's anti-Brexit campaign. We unite people across party lines with the solidarity between people and across borders. I've got a slightly exciting announcement now, which is, you know, this rally's gone on a while and, you know, I'm sure people will want to continue talking or whatever later, but we're going to do something slightly exciting and different. Because as other speakers have already said, the fight against Brexit isn't an alternative to class politics. The fight against hard Brexit is part of a class war being waged against us by a Tory millionaire elite. And the people who are funding the Tory party are the same people who are funding Leave. And we're going to go today and do a bit of a stunt to make that point, to make the point that Brexit is a billionaire con, not an anti-establishment movement. And if you want to be part of that stunt, and I encourage you all to do so, we're just going to be an entirely peaceful thing, but visually it's going to look cracking. And especially if you've got a camera or you're with the press, I thoroughly recommend going along. And that's going to be happening literally right now. So, over in that corner, you'll see a load of red flags and green flags waving. I want you to follow them. Follow the red flags. Let's go!